So now we are going to read the file now. So okay, what are we going to do? We are going to read the file. So what do we have to do for so file? First we have to get that file first. So how to get that file? So by using the file class dot txt text. We have that file. First we have to get that file. After getting that file, we have to create the object of the scanner class. Scanner sc equal to new scanner. Okay, so question for Parvati here. Parvati, just tell me this. I think you might have already used. So last time we have used system, now we are using F1. So do you know, can you identify the difference? Parvati, are you there? Okay, Raghu, can you try?
So what was the question, Ruby?
Okay, she says she's facing some issue. Yeah, so the scanner SC equal to new scanner, last time we used a system.in, now we are using F1. So can you tell me, or just can you guess that what is that, or what is the difference system.in and F1?
No idea.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So system.in, we have
can seen you that. Hear me now?
Yes, Parvati, we can.
Yeah. You are asking the difference, right? Scanner.
Yeah.
Mm. I know, like a scanner, we input, like we can say, like we can give the input and we can start giving the, while it is running, we can start giving the data. Say numbers or anything, we can print.
Yeah, yeah. Right. We can give the input, right?
Yeah.
So absolutely right. So scanner class is all about reading that input. So scanner class, what does it do? It reads the file. It reads the data. So it doesn't even matter that from where the data is coming. So it is meant to read the data. So scanner SC new scanner means this file. Let's say SC is going to read the files. And what files or what data it is going to read? So whatever you are going to mention here. So last time when we use system.in, so system.in means, so whatever the input we are going to give from the system, whatever the input we are going to provide from the system, that is going to read by the scanner class. Okay, scanner object SC. But here we are not giving that system.in. We are not reading something from the system. We are reading something from the file. And what is that file? File is firstfile.txt. In that firstfile.txt, okay, that instance is, that file object is given to the F1 instance, F1 variable. So that's the reason that we have mentioned F1 here. So we are going to read the data from the firstfile.txt. That is the meaning of it. Okay. Now, after that, we just get the object. We know that file is with us. How to read? So for that, we have to go into the loop, because there may be chance that there are multiple lines into it. So we have to go into the loop. Then there, what we have to do? We have to sc dot has next line. We have to use the has next line method. Okay, so we have to use this method. So inside this method, there is one more method called next line. So we are going to store whatever the information over there into one string S1 equal to sc dot next line. So next line is a method which is used to read the string value. Now we are going to print that S1. Okay, so after that, it's always best practice to close the F1. We have to close the F1. If you don't close the F1, it will create an error. So we'll close that. Dot close. Okay, now one thing, whatever to it.
Ravi, f1.close you have to use after that the bracket close, means the without next line.
Oh means, yeah, got it. So with that,
still it is coming. You use a while or okay with under try. Can you just remove try and catch?
We should not remove, because here definitely we will find an error. Do you know what error do we find here? File not found exception. Okay, don't worry, I'll correct it.
You can do the same f1.close after in finally, then without removing anything.
But what is the error? Okay, we'll not try to close it. Let's see what will happen. But we have to close that. Oh, okay. So we'll try it. Yeah, all right. Okay, fine guys, this is done now. Let's see. Yeah, so it is not getting read. So why? Because file might not be found. First file dot txt, everything is fine. Scanner is equal to F1.
Ravi, the file name which I can see, it's first file, right?
Right. Now again, I'm saying, guys, even from the error, we can learn something. Markan was absolutely right. And he, okay, let's see what was the error. So if I... It is simply mentioning that it is something went wrong. So rather than going to it, we'll see what is the error. Let's see, we'll get it from here.
See, file one is a CSV file, right? You give text. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Absolutely. Yeah, you're right. Everybody, so you're absolutely right. I'm just trying to show you what is the exception. I mean, what is the use of using this try and catch block? So file not find exception occur here. File not found exception. Can you see this? So file not found exception occur here. So this happens when you don't use the try and catch block. Okay. So rather than that, what did you do? You just mention it as a something went wrong. Okay. So exception was file not found, but you just sent out a message to the guy that file was not found or something had happened, something went wrong. Then this is the way that we are handling the exception. Then you may feel that, okay, for example, this is also an application, or we can say Skype is also an application which are using now. And we are in the middle of it. We are using this application. Suddenly something went wrong. Then what will you do? If it will completely stop, then what will you do? You can't do anything, right? But if you get any kind of exception or any kind of message here, then you can click over there, whether you want to get exit from here, or do you want to close the file? Do you want to stay on the file? If you get any kind of option, then how will it be? it will be good, right?
Yeah.
So that is all about the exception handling. So we are handling the exception. I know that here we don't have file. So what kind of exception it is going to throw? It is going to throw that file not found exception. But we are handling it by stating that something went wrong, just correct it. Or this is a message, something else we will can give. Any message we can give. So now I hope you understand. So using exceptions are very useful. Okay, while working on the file handling, because there may be a chance that you get the exception like a file not found, okay, file is already created, okay, these kind of exception. In order to handle that, we have to use this exception handling. Now let's see first file.txt. Now we are going to read whatever inside of it. This is last Java session. What is in the file? Yes, this is last Java session. Is it getting read or not? It is getting read. Clear, guys? Any doubts?
No.
Okay. So that's it. All about this exception handling and file handling.
Ravi, you can cover also delete one. Just try with one.
Delete the object?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. So delete the object is nothing but just directly deleting that object, right? se.delete. Or do you want to delete the file itself?
File itself.
Okay, fine. I'll delete that. So I'll first this is file.
Just paste it that delete. Code now before you do changes.
Yes, I'm doing the same. Okay, now let's see the deleting a file. So deleting a file is very easy, guys. You don't even require all these things. You simply say that file.delete, but we use that in if else f1 dot delete. Okay, and from here come to know whether the file is deleted or not. So deleted the file. Else something went wrong, fail to delete or could not delete. Okay, now let's see what will happen. See, can you observe here? The file went away.
Yes.
Okay, and here also it's a deleted the file. Now we'll try to one more time. Could not delete because there is nothing to delete. Okay. Anything
so
else?
For file. For file handling, so far we have covered how to create a file. Then we cover what is that? Read first, a file, right?
First we covered today. First was the exception handling, try block, right. Cache block, then finally block. After that, we just create one file. We just see that how to create a file, later that how to write that file, then we have seen that how to read the file, we have seen that how to delete the file.
Yeah, so I think this should be enough for file handling. So there are one more thing, but that I will not personally recommend, like change file permission, okay, from this path to that path. So that I will not recommend. It's okay. This these three or four concepts what Ravi covered, this is very important from your, you know, like Java point of view. You should know how to handle the files and all. I think we are done with file handling, right, Ravi?
Not only file handling, we're done with the Java.
Java, right. Sorry, my bad. And if, yeah, that's fine. Raghu, you have anything or Parvati?
No, Mark. So from tomorrow, we are starting with Selenium, right? Okay.
Raghu, anything from your side?
No, Ravi.
Okay, guys, I want to say few things over here. The Makan,
you can stop Raghu if we are done with this, I think.